latest figures from the Department of Employment, put the number out of work and claiming benefit at 3,381,893. Labour's spokesman on employment, Mr. John Prescott, said, however the government fiddled the statistics, they could do nothing to hide the thousands of redundancies happening day after day. Mr. Richard Wainwright for the Liberals said the figures were in ugly contrast to the...
Talk to the whole workforce.
Wealth, he said,
why not give them a lecture? You're quite a good teacher, you know.
It's become known that the...
word with the chairman about that little matter you raised with me the other day.
Oh, yeah.
You know, he agrees with me. We don't want to rock the boat at this juncture.
I want Everthorpe out of my factory. He's a bad influence.
Now, how do you mean, Vic?
I've told you. And he's...
He's what, Vic? Vic?
Forget it. What about my new core blower?
Now, that's approved.
Great.
Yeah, you're authorised to go up to 150 grand.
Oh. OK. I'll set up a meeting with Alton Office at Dusseldorf.
All right.
To introduce him.
No, they all know who I am. Let's get on with it.
Right! Now, you're supposed to start speeches with a funny story. But I don't have one ready. I'll be honest with you. Running this company is no joke. Now, you all know who I am. I'm the boss. I have a nasty habit of popping up on the shop floor just when you were thinking of going to the lab for a quiet smoke. And you think I'm God Almighty in this place, that I can do what I like. Well, I'm not. I can't do anything at all on my own. Now, I don't need to tell you that we're in a very competitive industry. A third of the engineering companies in the West Midlands... A third of the engineering companies have gone out of business in the West Midlands since 19...
What the hell do you think you're doing?
I've got a message for you.
Oh, sweetheart, get your tits out for the boys.
Check your meters off.
Get out of here.
Bend over, I'll drive you down.
You said get out of here.
Oh, go on, be a sport. It won't take long.
Get off, get off.
If you're selling our puppies, I'll have the one with a pink
nose. Yes, yes.
Come on.
Pringle balls, Pringle balls, Pringle all the day. Oh, what fun it is to work the Victor Wilcox way.
Victor Wilcox
way.
Pringle
balls.
Marion, stop it at once. Robyn!
Come
here,
on,
take this.
The rest of it,
come on.
Come on.
That's the end of the cabaret.
was saying. This is a very competitive industry. And a third of the engineering companies have gone out of business since 1980 in the West Midlands. And it's been very hard for a lot of people. It's going to get even harder. Not only for you, but for me.
I knew she had a part-time job, but I didn't know it was that. It's called a kissogram, apparently. Well, she didn't actually get as far as giving you a kiss.
Thank Christ for that.
It could have been worse. There's also something called a gorillagram.
She didn't tell you who set me up.
She didn't know.
I can guess any road.
Brian Everthorpe?
Has his fingerprints all over it.
Why don't you get rid of that man? After all, you're the boss.
I have thought of it, but...
But what?
You can have too many reasons for sacking a man. You begin to distrust your own motives. What do you think of this daft place?
It's incredible.
You wait till you get inside.
Thank you very much. Thanks.
Yes, sir.
Yes. 2 miles,
please.
2 pints.
What is
coming
then? Oh, it's only having to
be exhausted.
Oops.
It's been a lot of subsidence around here. The old mine working.
It's like a house in a fairy tale. Oh. Cheers.
Cheers. I've never bought draft bitter for a woman before.
Must have had a very limited experience of life then.
No, you're dead right there. Yeah. Sometimes when I'm lying awake in the small hours instead of counting sheep, I count the things I've never done.
Like what?
Oh, like I've never skied. I've never windsurfed. I never learned to play a musical instrument. Or speak a foreign language. Or ride a horse. I've never climbed a mountain. Or pitched a tent. Or caught a fish. I've never seen Niagara Falls. Or been up the Eiffel Tower. Or even the Tower of London. I've never... Oh, I could go on and on.
Still time?
No, it's too late. All I'm fit for is work. It's about the only thing I'm any good at.
Well, that's something. It's a lot. I'll buy you a drink next Wednesday. It's my last.
What?
Next week, it's the end of term. Must say, it's flown by.
I don't know how you people can justify your long holidays.
They are not holidays. We do research, you know, as well as teaching undergraduates.
Oh, sorry.
I've hardly touched my new book since Christmas. Having to come to Pringle's every Wednesday hasn't helped.
I'm going to Dusseldorf next Wednesday.
Oh. Well, then this is my last.
No, you've got to come with me to Dusseldorf.
I can't, I'm afraid.
You're my shadow. You've got to follow me wherever I go.
What are you going to Dusseldorf for?
Oh, I'm seeing some people about getting a new cord blower. It could be very interesting for you. We'd stay in a posh hotel, get taken out for meals. It's only 2 days, one night.
I have my women's writing seminars on a Thursday.
Well, can't somebody else do them for you?
No. No, I'm afraid it's out of the question. Gave me a shock. What are you doing here?
Just passing. Thought I'd drop in.
Hard at work as ever, I see, Robin. But does the world really need another book on 19th century fiction?
I don't know, but it's going to get one.
It's
My only hope of getting another job somewhere. Cheers.
Cheers. Have you seen Charles lately?
No, we've both been too busy. Why?
Did you know he's been seeing Debbie?
Seeing her?
Yes, seeing her.
Well, I knew he was going to watch her at her work.
He spent the night with her afterwards, at her house.
Well, he probably took her out to dinner and missed his train, so she put him up afterwards.
That's what Debbie says.
Well then, what's the fuss?
Suppose I told you it happened twice.
Twice?
Missing one train is unfortunate. Missing two looks suspicious, wouldn't you say?
How do you know all this, Basil? I mean, I thought you and Debbie never saw each other midweek.
Last Tuesday evening, I rang Debbie late and Charles answered the phone. And last night I followed them.
You what?
I followed them. First they went to a...
Basil, you're being completely paranoid.
Even paranoids have cheating girlfriends.
Look, I'm sure there's a perfectly simple explanation. I'll ask Charles, he's coming over this weekend.
Oh. Oh, well, that's a relief.
Why?
Well, Debbie claims she's staying with her parents this weekend. I was beginning to wonder. I don't know what you women see in Charles anyway. He seems a cold fish to me.
Got no wish to discuss Charles' attractions with you, Basil. Hello, Charles. Why not? You're not spending it with Debbie, then? Only Basil says you stayed overnight with her twice. No, I just wondered why you hadn't mentioned it. Why on earth should I be jealous of Debbie? I don't give a monkey's how much she earns. Yes, of course I know what the expression means, Charles. I thought it was rather appropriate. You haven't slept with her, then? What does that mean? Oh, I see. No, of course not. You're a completely free agent. Oh, I'm fine. I'm very busy. I'm going to Dusseldorf next week. Yes, Vic Wilcox is going on a business trip. It should be interesting. No, I'm busy the weekend after. No, of course I'm not angry, Charles. I just don't feel like seeing you. I'm a free agent too. Goodbye, Charles.
Well?
Well, what?
Have they slept together?
Not in the technical sense.
What do you mean, not in the technical sense?
He gave her a massage.
Is that all?
It's quite enough.
I've been thinking, how am I going to introduce you to the Germans? I can't go through all that rigmarole about the shadow scheme.
Well, I'll explain myself. I speak German.
God, you don't?
Ja, sicher. Ich habe in der Schule Deutsch gelernt.
What does that mean?
Yes, of course, I learned German in school.
I wish I could do that.
I'll be your interpreter then.
Oh, there's no need. The crowds all speak English.
Sir, can you fasten your seatbelt?
On behalf of Rummidge,
shall I take your cup, sir?
Marshall and crew, we would like to thank you for flying with us today, and we trust that you have enjoyed.
As a matter of fact, it might be useful if you don't let on you understand German.
Why?
Well, they sometimes speak German to each other in the middle of a meeting. I often wonder what they're saying.
All right, but how will you explain my presence?
Well, I'll say you're my personal assistant.
What does that mean?
Well, on business trips abroad, it usually means girlfriend. Well, they won't suspect you of speaking German.
I see. It's a good job I got dressed up for the occasion then, isn't it?
You look smashing, as a matter of fact.
Thank you. Than I expected.
Well, they had to rebuild from scratch after the war. We pretty near flattened the place.
Well, Centre Rummidge has been rebuilt too, but not like this.
They can afford it. I mean, we won the war and lost the peace, as they say. You see, in the boom years, when we were selling as much as we could make on our clapped-out machines and paying the unions whatever they asked for, the crowds were investing in new technology and hammering out sensible labour agreements.
I thought our problem was we import too much.
It's the same problem. I mean, that outfit of yours. Where was it made, as a matter of interest?
I've no idea.
You should have.
West Germany.
Well, there you are. That's great. See you later.
Dankeschön. You can't talk. You said you expected to pay £150,000 for this Korbler. Why not buy a British machine?
Because we don't make one. And that's another reason why we lost the peace.
The sales director is called Winkler, Robin, and he has Robin. A technical sidekick called Patch.
It's Winkler, not Winkler.
You're not supposed to know that.
Oh, I know, don't worry. I'll play my part. Mr. Winkler, we'll see you now.
Ah, thank you, sir.
Dann bis Mittag.
Bis später.
Well, what's your impression of Düsseldorf then, huh?
Well, you wouldn't think you were in a factory town, would you? Everything so clean and modern. I was saying to Vic in the car, actually, Mr. Winkle, at Düsseldorf, it's really so much nicer than I was expecting. Wasn't I, Vic?
Yeah.
I'm very glad to hear that, Miss Penrose. My name is Winkler, by the way. Well, here we have the machines.
Ooh, they're a nice colour, aren't they?
The units are fully automatic. There's a hoist system with hydraulic releases. Built into the machine for core box cooling.
How many moving parts in the cores can it have?
Up to five. The cores automatically discharged under the belt, as you see. The whole process is controlled automatically with manual overrided facilities.
Ah. Can I see it in operation?
Oh, certainly. Herr Kleid, würden Sie die Maschine mal laufen lassen für Herrn Wilcox, bitte?
Are you buying both machines, Vic?
Oh, no. These have been made for another customer.
I'm not buying one machine unless the price is right. How do you clean the blowheads?
The heads are changed automatically for cleaning.
I hear your boss is a very tough bargainer, Miss Penrose.
Couldn't say.
Who told you that?
My spies. We all have spies in industry.
Don't be alarmed.
Oh, it gave me quite a turn.
Well, when Dr. Patch has answered all Mr. Wilcox's questions, we can continue our business comfortably over lunch, right?
Ooh, that would be lovely.
Okay. Sie können die Maschine abstellen, wir brauchen sie nicht mehr. Danke vielmals.
I'll be honest with you. It's a great machine. It's exactly what I want. The trouble is, you want £170,000 for it. And I'm only authorized to spend up to £150,000.
Well, we might be able to arrange a discount.
How much?
1%.
Not worth talking about.
Oh, do you like a desert, Miss Penrose?
But is it? Oh, right. What about Black Forest Gatto? That should be good here, shouldn't it? I'll have just a tiny bit of that one, please.
I'm going to be late for my next appointment.
Do you have another appointment?
Yeah, if you'll excuse me, I've just got to make a quick phone call.
Of course. Can I order you some desert?
No, thanks.
I'd have some
cane
in this place.
Thank you, Jean. Would you please excuse us just for a moment?
Of course.
Was hältst du davon?
Thanks.
Ich fürchte, mein es ernst.
Und wenn wir nun seine 150.000 akzeptieren?
Zu dem Preis ist es nicht machbar. Ja, nicht mit Siemens-Systemen.
Von Siemens-Systemen war nicht ausdrücklich die Rede.
Auch wieder wahr.
I hope this cake is to your liking, Miss Penrose.
Well, it hasn't got much in the way of cherries in it. Oh, but it's very nice. Now, I must go and powder my nose, I'm afraid. Excuse me.
Yeah.
Maybe the restroom is down there.
It's not down there.
Ah, thanks so much.
Wir könnten ihm das kluge Mann. Das Holz ist gut.
Ja, möchten Sie noch?
Ja. Oh, there you are. I was just coming to look for you.
What's up?
But they're going to accept your prize. I overheard them.
Hey, that's fantastic.
Yes, but wait, there's a catch, I think. Patch said something about they couldn't do it with a something system. It sounded like semen.
Siemens.
Yes, that's it. And Schuldigan speaking. Anyway, then Winkler said, well, he hasn't specified Siemens.
The bastards. They're going to try and fob me off with an electromechanical system.
What?
Well, the machine we saw this morning has Siemens solid-state control and diagnostic systems for identifying faults. The older type is all switches and relays. Nowhere near as reliable. Nice work, Robin.
We have been discussing the problem. After all, we think we can meet your requirements at the figure you mentioned.
Now you're talking.
Let's all have a cognac to celebrate. Hmm? Oh. Would you like a cognac, too?
Oh, yes, that'll be lovely.
Fine. Vier cognac, bitte.
Now let's get this straight.
Yeah.
We're talking about your 22EX machine, right?
Yeah.
With Siemens solid-state systems.
Oh, we didn't specify that.
The 22EX is also supplied with Klugemann electromechanic controls. That is what we had in mind for the prize.
Then it's no deal. I'm only interested in solid state.
It's impossible.
Look, let's not waste any more of each other's time, Mr. Winkler.
Oh, we're going, Vic.
One moment, Mr. Wilcox. Please sit down. I'd like to discuss further with my colleague. Excuse us. Constable Wilcox.
Well, I think they might just bite the bullet. Winkler thought he had the deal sewed up. He can't bear the thought of it slipping through his fingers at the last moment.
Yeah?
Yeah? Okay.
They're coming back.
It's not that easy.
No, nothing ever is it?
Okay. 155,000 with Siemens solid state system. That is absolutely our last offer.
Okay. And let's not make any more mistakes, eh? This is your 22EX with Siemens solid state for 155,000 to be paid for in sterling in stages as per your outline quotation. That's 25% with order, 50% on delivery, 15% on being commissioned by your engineers, and 10% after 2 months satisfactory operation. Right?
Correct.
Done.
I wasn't misinformed about you, Mr. Wilcox.
When can I have the revised quotation?
It will be ready for collection at my office tomorrow morning.
Right. We'll be off then. Cheers.
Cheers. Goodbye, Miss Penrose. I hope you will enjoy your stay at Düsseldorf.
Auf Wiedersehen, Herr Winkler. Ich würde mich freuen, wenn der Rest meines Besuches so erfreulich wird wie dieses köstliche Mittagessen. Wiedersehen.
Wiedersehen, Mr. Winkler. Turn the tables on the boogers. At £155,000, it's a slip.
Not so loud.
They can't back out now.
He winked to his face when he spoke German to him. What did you say?
I simply said that I would be very happy if the rest of my stay was as enjoyable as the delicious lunch. I felt rather sorry for him, actually.
Hey, let's explore Düsseldorf before we go to the Schloss.
OK, that'll be great. Würden Sie bitte zur Altstadt bringen?
Selbstverständlich. Wir sind jetzt schon zu spät dran.
God, say something in German again.
I just told him to take us to the old town. Is that OK?
Don't you like it?
No, it's wonderful. I mean, this has to be the most bizarre setting for a discotheque I ever saw in my life.
You look fantastic in that dress, Robyn. Really suits you.
I don't think I should have any more champagne.
Well, it's a special occasion. Here's to the new machine.
Here's to it. I suppose if I hadn't been here, Herr Winkler would have fixed you up with a call girl for the night.
What?
Isn't that what usually happens when businessmen go abroad?
Not to me, it doesn't.
Does Marjorie know I'm here with you?
I can't remember whether I mentioned it.
Would she mind?
Why should she?
Perhaps you'd like to have come herself.
Marjorie? No.
Yeah.
Let's dance.
I can't do that sort of dancing.
What?
You just sort of stand there and twitch instead of holding on to somebody.
You can hold on to me.
Hey, come back! I can't do this.
You're doing fine. Just let yourself go.
I don't know how to. It's not in my nature.
Oh, poor Vic.
Robyn, come here!
Come on, you're not trying!
I can't do it!
If you really hate it, we'll sit down.
Hey, listen, that song.
No?
It's Jennifer Rush. It's my favourite.
Your voice is warm and tender.
Treffer, wenn morgen früh am Flughafen wäre, dann gleich zur Bank.
Robyn.
Wait a minute. All in good time. Oh. Careful, Vic. You'll tear my dress.
Oh. Sorry.
I wonder if there's any champagne.
I haven't done this sort of thing before, you say.
You don't have to do anything if you don't want to.
Oh, I want to. I love you.
Don't be silly, Vic. That song's gone to your head.
Oh. Now it will be our song.
Well, aren't you having some? You're not afraid of being impotent, are you? Because if it happens, it doesn't matter, all right?
I don't think it'll be a problem.
You could just give me a massage, if you like.
No, I want to make love.
Well, massage is a non-phallic way of making love.
I'm a phallic sort of bloke.
Oh. Made in Italy. Fail the patriotic test again. Fabriqué en France. Dear, oh dear. Well, aren't you going to get undressed too?
Yeah.
Viva España. Olé. Christian Dior. Encore la France. Now let me see. These should be British anyway. Yes. I always buy my knickers from Marks and Spencer's.
You're beautiful.
My, what a knobstick.
Why'd you call it that?
Private joke. Have you got a condom?
No.
Fortunately, I have. Vic.
I've been in love with you for weeks.
But there's no such thing. It's a rhetorical device, a bourgeois fallacy.
Haven't you ever been in love then?
Oh. When I was younger, I allowed myself to be constructed by the discourse of romantic love for a while, yes.
What the hell does that mean?
Well, we aren't essences, Vic. I mean, we aren't unique, individual essences existing prior to language. There is only language.
What about this?
Language and biology. I mean, of course, we all have bodies and physical needs. When you touch me there, it gives me pleasure.
It gives me pleasure too.
But the discourse of romantic love pretends that your finger and my clitoris are extensions of two unique selves who need each other and only each other and can't be happy without each other forever and ever. Amen.
That's right. That's exactly how I feel.
But
the post-structuralist theory of the subject has rendered that quite untenable. I mean, desire is a sentient...
Do you think we could possibly stop talking now?
All right. But I prefer to be on top.
Dann kann man mit Euro-Scheck bezahlen. Das ist doch gleich viel einfacher, wirklich.
Rein? Herein!
Oh. Good morning. How are you? I ordered breakfast from room service, did you?
Oh, I wasn't very hungry.
Coffee was excellent. There's still some left, I think. If you'd like some, help yourself.
What are we going to do?
Well, I thought I might go for a swim, actually. You know, while you're sorting out your contract.
No, I meant... What are we going to do about last night?
Well, we haven't got to do anything about it, have we? I mean, we both got a bit carried away. But it was nice.
Nice? Is that all you got to say about it? Nice? It was wonderful.
All right, it was wonderful.
Don't mock me.
I'm not mocking you.
I suppose it was nothing special to you, just a, what do they call it? One-night stand.
I haven't slept with anybody except Charles for years, and I'm not seeing him at the moment. Not that it's any of your business.
So it was love, then?
I keep telling you, there's no such thing. Love, that sort of love, is a literary con-trick.
I don't believe that.
Oh, good God.
Last night you called me darling.
Say all kinds of things when they're in bed together. It doesn't mean anything.
It does to me. Look, I've got to go. I'll meet you for lunch where we ate yesterday. 1 o'clock.
Können Sie mich bitte mit British Airways verbinden?
Why did you run away?
I had things to do.
Can I come in?
What for?
I want to talk.
Well, as long as it's not about love or last night.
You know, that's what I want to talk about.
That's the condition.
All right.
So, when will you get this new toy of yours, then?
Oh, I should think about 6 to 9 months. The sooner the better, really. Well, there'll be fewer breakdowns and less overtime to make up for them, and, of course, I'll save on manpower.
Why?
Well, the new machine will replace half a dozen old ones, so, most of the operators will be redundant.
But that's terrible.
Well, it stands to reason. That's why you buy an automatic machine, to cut labour costs.
If I'd known this, I would never have helped you buy the wretched thing.
You can't afford to be sentimental about a few men being laid off.
Sentimental? Look who's talking. I mean, this is the man whose knees go weak at the sound of Jennifer Rush, the man who believes...
I'm talking about business. You don't understand.
Well, I understand that men who have jobs right now won't have them this time next year, thanks to you, me and Herr Winkler.
Those old machines had to be renewed sooner or later. They're always breaking down, very tricky to operate. Well, you know yourself, we're always having trouble.
You don't mean to say that Danny Ram operates one of those machines?
I thought you knew.
Oh, shit!
I'll find another job for him.
Oh, right, by firing somebody else.
Not necessarily.
No, not necessarily. You are playing with people's lives.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. You're offering me Danny Ram's job as a sop. A bribe, a present, like men give their mistresses strings of pearls.
I don't want you to be my mistress. I want you to be my wife.
You're out of your mind. Have you forgotten you've got a wife already?
I'll get a divorce.
I refuse to listen to any more of this. I think you better go home. I've got a lot of essays to mark. Term ends tomorrow.
My marriage has been dead for years. We have nothing in common anymore, Marjorie and me.
What do you think we've got in common?
Last night?
Oh, shut up about last night. That was just a fuck. Nothing more, nothing less. God, anybody would think it had never happened before in the history of the world.
It never did to me. Not like that.
Oh, go away! Go home, for God's sake! Home.
Morning, Vic. I thought you'd like to see the first complete printout of our inventory.
Oh, yes.
Look,
These are our stocks of raw materials. As soon as any item falls below a certain level, the computer automatically searches the order file for the relevant product and triggers a command to repurchase as appropriate. We need never get caught with our pants down again.
Nice.
Nice. It's bloody magic. Buying that computer is the best thing you ever did.
Wait until you see the new automatic core blower.
Oh, that should be something. You know, there's a real buzz about this place with all the capital investment. Makes you quite glad to come to work. You all right, Vic?
Yeah, I'm just a bit tired, that's all.
Shall I leave this stuff with you?
Yes, Tom. Leave it with me.
All we need now is that new spectrometer, eh?
Yeah.
Hello, this is Robyn Penrose speaking. I'm sorry I'm not available to take your call at the moment. Please leave a message with your name, number, and time of call, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Please speak after the beep.
For?
I've been jogging. Got caught in the rain.
Jogging? You?
I thought it was time I did some exercise. Get me weighed down.
Pull yourself an injury if you're not careful. What's that van doing here just now?
I'm delivering a sunbed. Don't worry, it's only rented.
What do you want a sunbed for?
Get a nice tan before we go on holiday.
You need your head tested.
Artemis. Originally a fertility goddess, she later became the Virgin Huntress, patron of chastity and protector of women. The painting depicts the story of Actaeon, who watched Diana and her nymphs bathing. The goddess, outraged by this intrusion, turned him into a stag and, in punishment, hunted him to death with his own hounds. This painting is by an unknown artist, probably a student of Titian, since it contains many features of a famous painting by Titian in the National Gallery of Scotland. The black maidservant, who is in place of the usual nymph, is thought to represent the dark side of Diana, the dark side of the moon, if you like, since Diana was also associated with the moon. This picture also has a very modern feeling to it, in that it raises the whole question of voyeurism in relation to paintings of the nude, the male gaze at the naked female figure.